Hey guys, it's Cheyenne. Welcome back to my channel. For today's video, we are gonna be testing out a new cleansing balm. It is literally the end of the day right now. I just threw my hair up. I look a little oily, a little bit tired, but I just got this in the mail and I really wanted to try it on camera, first impressions with you guys. So this is what you're getting. So this is the Pond's Cleansing Balm. It says it melts makeup, moisturizes skin. I did get this sent to me for free through Influencer. If you guys don't know what that is, it is a website or an app where you review products and like just anything. Like you could review your Maybelline Age Rewind or whatever you have. It's all types of different stuff. It could be pet products, household items, anything. You review them, and then sometimes you get sent free things as well to review, and they want your honest opinion. Like, I have given some harsh reviews before, and like, they're not a company that will like stop sending you anything because they just send you other brands' products. I hope I'm making sense. I'll link them, but this is the box that it comes in, which is cute. It's super cute. This is the little promotional card. So it's Pond's. It is a cleansing balm. It says a solid makeup remover balm that melts away stubborn makeup like a dream. This could be amazing. So it says what it is, a unique blend of oils and cleansing essence pressed into a solid balm. Once massaged into the skin, it transforms into a silky oil, melting away stubborn makeup and removing impurities. After rinsing, skin is left clean, soft, and radiant. It says why you'll love it. Transforms into a silky oil, no harsh scrubbing or tugging, which I appreciate because my skin has already been through enough. She's been through enough. It says it'll hydrate skin, leaving it glowing and radiant. And you know, a bitch wants to glow, so yes. And delivers a premium K-beauty experience at an affordable price. Not bad. So it says how to use it. It says a little goes a long way, so just start with a small amount. Massage onto dry skin. So you want to do this before you wet your face. And then rinse it with warm water. And it said it should just come right off. So super pumped. I love that they include these little things because sometimes when you're testing a new product, it's kind of hard and you're like, how am I supposed to use this? So Influencer always includes that. So first things first, well, my hair's already falling, but first things first, gotta remove my lashes because I do not want these to get ruined. These are actually the Batty B lashes that are Jenny69. I think it's Jenny69 or it's Jenny69. Jenny. Everyone knows her. She's amazing, but she's the founder of Batty B Lash. These are the ones that I was wearing today. Like, can we have a moment? And can we have a moment for this packaging? Like, I know this is not a Batty B Lash review, but damn. Okay, so now that I'm looking even more sad, this packaging is actually really, really cute. I love pink and mint together. I just think it's super cute. So let's pop it open. And of course it has one of these, so let's get it off. Oh my gosh, I always hate trying to peel this, so. It smells really, smells fresh, a little bit floral, but nice. Okay, so it said to try to do a small amount, so I'm just gonna use my nail, and we are gonna do a thumbnail amount. And kind of like go like this and let's just go straight into the eyes. Let's just do it. Oh my God. They weren't kidding. I took it off so fast. I look crazy right now. I look crazy. Okay. Now let's see if it'll take off these Kylie liquid lips. Cause those are the true test of time. Oh my God, guys. What? It literally melted off everything. Oh my God, this is amazing. It melted away the Kylie. Sometimes I have to literally like scrub to get that off normally, which I mean, I love that her liquid lipsticks are gonna last me all day, don't get me wrong, but sometimes towards the end of the night, a bitch just wants to go to bed. So, I don't even know if I need to keep rubbing. Like, I feel like it got rid of everything. And I'm just kind of like, just continuing. I am gonna rinse really quick with warm water and I'm gonna be right back. Okay, and I am back. It took everything off for the most part. I mean, I have a little bit of eye makeup I can see underneath. I feel like I didn't scrub my eyes like that much, but like if I like pick at it, like there's no like eye makeup still left, if that makes sense. I am like super shocked. I'm gonna be super honest. This, like, for it to take that much off like that quickly was really cool. For it to take off the Kylie Liquid lip, and ignore that my lips are red, they're just chapped. They've just been through it this week. I've been just trying lots of things on them. But that thoroughly impressed me, because those, like, I normally have to scrub. I am just gonna do a quick little test, and I'm gonna take a makeup wipe and just see if there's any face makeup still on my face. We're just gonna go like that. A little bit. So now I had a lot of makeup on to begin with, so I'm wondering if, one, I used it properly because it's my first time. I'm just going all over to see like what is really left of my makeup, or I think this would be a good first starter bit to your makeup. Like, I think you should do this first to get off that first bit of makeup and then go in with your normal cleanser. But to get the first bit of makeup off, like, damn, I think it did a really good job. I always double cleanse anyway. I'm just going around to see what was left. So about that was still left on, but I'm just comparing it to everything else that I use, because I am a cake face. I put on a ton of makeup and I always have to double cleanse my face if I don't use like an actual like makeup wipe first. So I'm not trashing this product. I think this product's amazing. If you were someone who wasn't a total cake face and just wore like a normal amount of makeup, I think this would take off everything. For me, I always have to double cleanse, like especially even with like my 4-3 Beauty. I use the oil-based remover first to like work everything in, and then I go in with a cleanser, and then I'll go in with a scrub sometimes after, just to really make sure my skin is clean. If you guys have watched some of my skincare videos before, you know I'm crazy. So I do want to give that little bit of background before you're like looking at the makeup wipe and like, damn, there was a lot still on her face. Yeah, but there would be even if I use like my 4-3 Beauty or my Bliss. Like, there's lots of stuff that I use for my skincare, like even my Bliss skincare. I'll do the makeup melt, and then I'll do the Pore Patrol, and then I'll do the scrub. So there's like a lot that I'll do to get everything off. But for the way that this works, this is amazing. I'm gonna probably use this every day. I hope that I don't have any allergic reactions from it. It felt really great on my skin, to be honest. It felt really nourishing. The scent wasn't super crazy. Actually, I like it. Like, it's a light, like, kind of like rose type of floral fragrance, if that makes sense. But I love this. I will definitely leave it in the description box below if like anything weird happens, like I get any reactions. Because my skin is pretty clear for the most part right now, except for this. But this has been here for like a week and a half now, and I think she's just like moved in and just permanently staying. So we need to like name her, because she won't go away. But like, she's not raised, she's just a dot on my face now. But I mean, other than that, like, the skin looks pretty good. So I will let you guys know if I break out or anything weird in the description box. But first impressions, this is amazing. I really, really like it. I am really excited. Like, you guys saw, like, I was just like, I'm still kind of in shock, because like, even so I wanted to compare it to this. I did a products I hate video a long time ago, and this was in it. So this is the Clinique Take the Day Off. I just keep it because it was expensive and I don't use it anymore. But this product felt really thick on my skin, and like, I had a hard time getting it off, and it caused me to break out really bad. And this product felt way better, and I'm sure it's a fraction of the price. But that I prefer over this. So if you already like the Clinique Take the Day Off, you're for sure gonna really like this. If you didn't like this, you'll probably like this, because this was just not the business for me. Like, it does take your makeup off, but the residue, ugh. I hate, absolutely did not like that product. But I'm gonna stop rambling now, because this video is already long. Yes, this is Shy approved. I love this. I'm gonna be reaching for this a heck of a lot more. And I hope you guys enjoyed this little video. And if you're looking for a good makeup remover, maybe it'll be something that you'll pick up. But thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you next time. Bye guys.